glad you're watching this week. First of all, I want to take a moment to invite you to my upcoming Icing Conference. If you've never been to an Icing Conference, I really want you to come. You will never regret coming because we're going to learn how to pursue the dreams, the plans, the goals that God has for our lives. And you might be like, what is icing? Well, I'm glad you asked. Icing actually means something added to something good to make it even better. Cake is good, but the icing makes it better. And so at this next Icing Conference, it's September 14th. It's for women only. I always say it's between the ages of 13 to 99. But we are going to the Fort Worth Convention Center here in Dallas, Fort Worth. And I'm going to be talking about taking action towards your dreams. I heard a success coach make this statement. He said the one thing that seems to separate winners from losers more than anything else is winners simply take action. They do what needs to be done. So we're going to increase our desire to get results in our lives and learn how to take action. So mark your calendar September 14th. But this month, I'm excited. We're talking about my brand new book, Untangle, which is all about breaking wrong soul ties and pursuing your purpose. Not only do we have the English version, but right now as you're watching this, I just got back from France, where we introduced the French version of Untangle, Délier, and preaching it all over Paris, seeing women break free from wrong soul ties. You know, I taught this message at one of the Icing conferences, and before I actually went to the service, you know, that night, I'm at home, I'm praying, I'm going over my notes, and I'm telling you, Satan was messing with my mind. And he just kept telling me, you know, this is an isolated message. It's only for a little handful of people. I kept thinking there's going to be like three teenagers at the altar that need to break free from wrong soul ties. And I would preach it for the three. But I'm telling you, I got there that night. I preached this message on breaking soul ties. And I would say 90% of the crowd came forward needing to be free from a wrong relationship, a soul tie from the past, maybe one from last night, whatever. But they knew they needed to break free. I'm telling you, I was just crying, watching all these women, young and old, come forward to be free from those wrong attachments. You know, soul ties are so powerful. A soul tie is just an emotional bond or a connection that unites you with someone else. Soul ties are so powerful, and they're responsible for the pain you feel when a relationship ends. You know, especially one where you've been intimate with someone, you've shared a lot with each other. And of course, the more intimate you are, if it's moved into the sexual arena, then the harder it is to break free. I know from experience. I know also what it's like to be deceived and to stay in a wrong relationship, even though you know God's telling you to get out. But we just have these unique abilities to justify staying in wrong relationships, especially if you've been intimate with someone. You know, in this new book, I talk about from my own life how I even got into an abusive relationship, but it lasted for a couple of years. And I wouldn't even get out of it, even though it was physically abusive. I wouldn't get out. Why? Because of soul ties, because of how intimate we'd been, all the time we'd spent together. You know, soul ties can be very deceiving. Well, what is deception? It's simply believing a lie. Well, if you believe a lie, then to you it's the truth, right? So we have to learn how to wake up, how to recognize if we're in a wrong relationship, a wrong soul tie, and then the action steps to truly break free. And once you break free, even though the relationship ends, you could still be reliving it right here in your thought life. You could still be tormented. You could still be harassed. And you know, when you continually think about something, unless you learn how to take control of those thoughts, you'll go right back to it. Because, you know, whatever stays in your mind, it eventually shows up in your life. You will go right back to that old relationship or get involved in another wrong one. So one of the things that I talk about with soul ties are indicators. There are certain indicators in our lives that reveal if we have a wrong soul tie or we're in a wrong relationship. Well, one of them is disobedience. Disobedience to God. You know, if you're in a relationship and you know in your heart, I mean deep down inside, you got to get beyond what your feelings are saying, but you know deep down inside that you're disobeying God, I'm telling you, you will stay miserable. And as much as I don't want to admit this, the Bible says in Deuteronomy that when we obey God, we've opened the door for blessings to come on our lives. But when we disobey God, we have opened the door for a curse to come on our lives. You know, those are those types of scriptures that you just kind of want to ignore and pretend they're not there, but they're there. And I know from experience where in the past, when I opened the door by disobeying God, I mean flat out disobeying Him and doing what I knew in my spirit was not in line with God's word, I knew I opened the door to a curse. I experienced a type of misery that would not go away, a tormented mind. I mean, I know what it's like now to fight for peace in your mind, but disobedience opens a door to that curse. Listen to this testimony that came in from someone named AJ. She said, I just ended a relationship that I felt God was telling me to sever for a very long time. I tried so many times to maintain the relationship and justify the wrong that we were doing. We had a history with each other, so you can imagine the thoughts that were helping me to continue to justify why I should stay in this relationship. It's been a few days since I left, but I had to leave quickly and obey God before this unholy soul tie continued. Thanks for the information. It is empowering me to obey God, stay away from my past relationship, and continue in faith. Well, AJ will never regret obeying God. And I want you to know, whatever God's telling you to do, as painful as it seems right now, to get out of a wrong relationship, to break free, do what God's telling you to do. Because God always rewards obedience. And remember, God sees down the road. He sees something that maybe you don't see right now. All you can see are, you know, the memories and the moments you've shared and how much you love this person. But if God's telling you to break free, you have to obey what God's telling you to do or you'll stay miserable. I heard a minister say that if it feels like you're stuck in your life, you feel like you're not getting beyond something, he said, go back to the last thing you know God told you to do and see if you did it. Because if you didn't, God will keep bringing you back to it, bringing you back to it. You will never move beyond your current situation. You'll never move beyond, you know, what you're doing right now until you obey God. I heard another statement that said, God will not advance His instructions for your life beyond your last act of disobedience. So if you want to move beyond, you want to be somewhere else next month at this time, then obey what God's telling you to do. So I want you to get my new book, Untangle, and I believe it'll give you some action steps and things to do to get rid of the torment, the memories, and to have peace in your mind and a plan to pursue. So, thank you for watching me, and I'll see you next time.